Good morning, friends. Today I will teach you which are the main reference books for UPSC examination, especially for IAS, that means India Administrative Service. So to begin with the UPSC exam, if you are focused and very hard worker, you have to determine yourself, then you can only have to enter and this, because if you don't have to scope or you can't scope yourself to the examination and you don't have the patience, you can't crack this examination. And another announcement, luck is very much important determinator in the competitive exams, and in IAS luck is very much important for you, but we can't stay with the luck only, so we have to work hard. So today I will teach you which are the important books for NCERT, for the UPSC exam, especially IAS. To begin your journey, you have to must or any other thing, you have to mostly read the NCERT starting from class 6 to 12 in subject like history, geography, social science, sociology, economy, polity, and other books which are relevant in your examination. So starting from subjects, in polity you can start your reading from NCERT class 6 political science polity book up to 12th level. In addition to that, you can read M. Lakshmikant or D.D. Basu. In geography, you can read NCERT starting from class 6 to 12. Besides this, you can refer G.C. Leung book. In history, you can read the NCERT starting from class 6 to class 12 in addition, or you can read Tamil Nadu Board's 11th and 12th class history book. In addition to that, you can read Spectrum, that was very much essential, especially the modern India, where you can get very factual data. Also, you can refer Bipin Chandra. In economy, you can refer the NCERT books, especially the macroeconomics book of NCERT. Besides that, you can refer Ramesh Singh or Sriram IAS note. In ecology, you have to start your journey via NCERT, especially the 11th and 12th class NCERT book. After reading that, you can refer Shankar IAS ecology book or Irak Barucha ecology book. So in science and tech, you have to refer Spectrum science and tech book. Also, you can refer Science Reporter. Another important thing, in art and culture, you have to refer NCERTs of 11th and 12th. After then, you can refer Nitin Singhania or CCERT book or Spectrum's book. These are some of the reference books. Besides this, the most essential thing is, the examination was not static and was very dynamic in nature, so you have to update yourself on the regular basis. To regularly update yourself, you have to or must to read the Hindu and read only one newspaper, because wasting time on reading newspaper is also very much blunder. So you have to read the Hindu very much thoroughly in articles as well as the editorials, because both are important in your prelims as well as in mains, also in for your interviews. So you have to read India Yearbook, which was published by the government itself, which of the articles which was very much relevant for your examination only. Also you have to refer Economic Survey, the full version, not the gist, because there is no gist The statement can be from any line of economic survey that was published by the government of India. In addition to it, you can refer PIB on your regular basis via your website or the Android app, which was also available on the Play Store. Also, you can refer PRS India for important legislations. And in your UPSC exam, you can forget Yojana. It was very much relevant for your mains because you get many answer writing skills from there. Also, you know very much new programs which were much relevant for your prelims. In case of optional students like geography, sociology, anthropology, economy and other optionals which were very much in dynamic in nature, they must have to refer Kurukshetra because it will nourish their answer writing skills. And an important announcement, you need to or must have to work hard minimum for 12 hours. Remember, minimum for 12 hours with efficiency and sustainability. But the maximum should be 15 hours or less. You never have to study more than 15 hours because your body needs some type of rest. So you have to sustainable it, because if you read 12 hours today, 1 hour tomorrow, it was not sustainability, but you have to refer the sustainability. And you have to make a workout on regular basis because it will make you fresh and constant, help in constanting your studies. Another thing, people recognize you only after you become succeed. Until you succeed, they will demoralize you, criticize you and demotivate you. Especially your relatives, they are very much dangerous for your examination, and so you have to ignore them. And in UPSC exam, there is no one is your friend, all are competitors. So you will never have to make friendship and a large number of friends, because they will make use of you for their personal gain. You can't recognize anyone, you can't know anyone. You have to protect yourself, have to ignore them, because book is the best friend of you. If possible, keep out from the WhatsApp group, Facebook groups, Twitter groups and many other gossiping groups also. It will eat your time. So drink a lot of water because it has some energy and being helpful for your studying. If possible, stay out from the family if they are not supportive. If they are supportive, you have to stay with them because they will motivate you and increase your potentiality. Another important thing, without internet, you can't go one step ahead. So make the use of internet on the white internet, not the dark internet, because there are a lot of things which can be referred to as the dark internet. So work hard, be care to your health, and exclude other things whenever you are studying. Forget anything, evenly your father, mother, if they are not supporting, they will demoralize you. So kindly focus on your studies and stay at best of luck.